Hello, everyone. Welcome to our liver transplant program at Northwestern Medicine. I'm Dr. Juan Carlos Caicedo. I'm a transplant surgeon. I'm the surgical director of our liver transplant program at Northwestern Memorial Hospital. Today, we're going to discuss some important aspects about the liver transplant orientation and evaluation day. What is going to happen? And we want to set up some expectations for all of you. We hope that at the end of this talk, you're going to write down all your questions, and our team, as soon as we see you here at the hospital, will be more than happy to answer all your questions. What we're going to discuss today is what to expect during the liver transplant orientation evaluation day. What are our goals? Our goals are to, first of all, provide some information about liver transplantation, and second, to answer three main questions. The questions are, if the patient needs a liver transplant, second, if there is any medical, surgical, or psychosocial contraindication, and third, how can we get a liver transplant to your patient? And the patient and family will interact with our liver transplant team during the evaluation day. And as I mentioned before, our team will be more than happy to answer your questions or concerns. Then who needs a liver transplant? There's two main reasons why patients may need a liver transplant. One, if they have acute hepatic failure or anything that has damaged the liver irreversibly in an acute fashion. Or most often, patient has chronic hepatic failure. That means that they have hepatic cirrhosis associated with complication. This is what we call complicated cirrhosis. And a liver transplant may be the only hope for those patients. What is the problem in the US as well in the world? The main issue is that there's a lot of patients waiting for a liver transplant. In the US, there's more than 13,000 patients with liver failure waiting for a liver transplant, and they have a high mortality while they are waiting for a liver transplant. The average mortality is between 15 to 20%. And unfortunately, more than 2,000 patients die or are too sick to get a transplant per year. And what is the main problem? The main problem is that there's not enough liver donors for all patients. And only around 8,000 liver transplants are performed per year in the US. From them, 94% are from deceased donors and 6% are from living donors. Here at Northwestern, actually, our proportion of living donor liver transplants is higher, is around 10 to 15%, and in Lowry Children's, is 25%. Now, I think it's important for you to know more about our Northwestern Medicine liver transplant program. We have a very experienced team. We have been doing liver transplant for more than 25 years. We have done by now more than 2,200 liver transplants. And we have been doing living donor liver transplant for more than 20 years. And we have performed more than 360 living donor liver donations, more than 100 for pediatric recipients, and more than 260 for adult recipients. And by the way, we have the largest liver transplant program in Illinois and one of the largest in the whole country. And we at Northwestern Memorial Hospital performed the first laparoscopic assisted right donor hepatectomy in the world in 2006. And this is the way that we're currently doing it. One of the advantages that we have here at Northwestern Memorial Hospital is that we perform all types of liver transplants. Most of the centers, they can do only whole liver transplant. Here at Northwestern, not only we can do a whole liver transplant, we can do partial liver transplants from deceased donors as well from living donors. And that's why a higher proportion of our listed patients will receive a liver transplant compared to most of the programs in the nation, because we really maximize the utilization of liver donors. And our outcomes continue to be excellent and are above the national norms. And you can see our outcomes compared to any other program in the country visiting this website, the www.srtr.org. And you can get updated information and outcomes data by center in the country. Now, the liver transplant evaluation, as I mentioned, the goal actually is modify and optimize conditions to make patients transplantable. Then we're going to do a medical evaluation, a surgical evaluation, as well as psychosocial evaluation. Let's start talking about the medical evaluation. In this medical evaluation, we're going to check your heart, your lungs, kidneys. We're going to check if there's an infection, even a cavity in your mouth. That is an infection. Those bacteria can migrate to your brain. That is called meningitis, or can migrate to your bloodstream. It's called sepsis, and people can die from that. And as we don't want that to happen, then we are going to assess that at front. We're going to check if there's cancer outside of your liver. And if there's any cancer, we have to deal with that. As soon as you are cured from your cancer, we can proceed with transplantation. And we're going to check how frail you are or malnourished, and we're going to work to improve those conditions. And if you're obese, we're going to help you to lose weight in a healthy manner. And the recovery after liver transplant depends on how sick, weak, frail, and malnourished the patient is before transplant. This is essential to remember. Optimization of nutrition or physical activity before liver transplantation is essential to enhance recovery after transplant. That's why we want to make sure that you're strong going into the transplant, to make sure that you recover faster after the transplant to have the best outcome for you and your family. Then we're going to do a surgical evaluation. We're going to evaluate if there's previous surgeries. We're going to evaluate your hepatic vessels, your hepatic artery, portal vein, hepatic veins, inferior vena cava. We're going to analyze how are your bile ducts. And if there's problems with those, we have a multidisciplinary team, including transplant surgery, interventional radiology, and interventional gastroenterology, that perform innovative treatments to solve anatomical issues to help patients to become transplantable. Part of the procedures that our team are performing are TIPS, thrombectomy, embolization, liver-directed therapies, including radioembolization with Y90, and our team probably is one of the teams in the world that has the highest experience. And radiofrequency ablation and other liver-directed therapies are available here at Northwestern. And also, our team is going to perform a psychosocial evaluation. We have a team of psychiatrists, social workers, psychologists that will assess your psychiatric condition, your abstinence to alcohol and recreational drugs. This is very important. And we're going to check your compliance with therapies, counseling, and AA meetings. And we're going to check your social support and your financial needs and insurance coverage. Now, how the patient can receive a liver transplant then depends on many factors, including the patient's MELD sodium score. As you know, the MELD sodium score is a score that tells us what is the risk of mortality at 90 days. The highest MELD score is 40. The risk of mortality could be as high as 70 to 80%, depends on the comorbidities. But the low MELD score, less than 15, is still the risk of mortality could be around 15 to 20%, depends on comorbidities. Then for patients who has high MELD score, they will have high priority for deceased donors, and that's why for them, plan A is a deceased donor, brain death, whole liver transplant. But plan B for those, if we don't have a deceased donor, brain death, whole liver transplant, we can do donors after cardiac death, whole liver transplant, or donors who meet risk criteria. For patients who has a low MELD score, less than 25, then plan A for them, as they don't have high priority for deceased donors, plan A for them, patients with low MELD score, less than 25, is a living donor liver transplantation, and we have that available here at Northwestern Memorial Hospital. Plan B for those patients also are donors after cardiac death, whole liver transplant, donors who meet a risk criteria, and a split liver transplant. We can divide the liver in two and transplant two people. If the liver was allocated to a small baby in Lurie Children's Hospital, we can take a piece for that baby, and the rest that we are not using, we can use it to an adult recipient, and that is called a split liver transplant. And we are one of the few in the nation that do these type of procedures. Then now, let's talk about a living liver donation. Then who can be considered? First of all, somebody that is motivated by altruistic reasons without coercion, somebody they are between 18 to 50 years old. if they are between 50 and 55 years, if they are marathon runners, meaning that they're in great shape. And usually the BMI is less than 30. BMI is a relation between the height and weight of the patient. And the issue here in US is a big problem. Usually 60 to 70% of our population in the country are obese or overweight. And obesity is associated with fatty liver disease. Even though we can remove without problem 70% of the liver in somebody that is healthy, and by 3 months that liver will regenerate without issues, if there's fat infiltration in the liver associated with, for example, obesity, the regeneration of that liver is affected and in the donor, as well the function of that graft that we're going to remove is not going to work as well in the recipient. That's why it's advisable for patients or potential donors that are obese to lose weight, and they can improve their health, and then eventually they can donate. That's why obesity is a relative contraindication, and we have had patients here or donors that have lost up to 120 pounds, and they have been able to donate a liver afterwards. And donors need to be in a good health with no major medical psychiatric illnesses. Usually, people or patients need to have multiple potential donors, because 60 to 80% of donors are ruled out for medical, surgical, or psychosocial reasons. And if somebody can be a donor, they can become champions for that patient. They can talk to the family and friends, and they can share the patient's story. They can go to church, and they can share the patient's story in social media, and that can help to find potential living donors. Now, what are the next steps? A patient needs to complete the liver transplant workup as soon as possible. As soon as they are ready to be listed, you can attend or watch the next talk to learn about liver transplant options, what patients, family, and friends need to know. If you are interested to become a living donor, you can call us to our living donor liver office to this number, 312-695-0340. And potential living liver donor needs to fill out a health questionnaire that you can find in our website under nm.org/livertransplantation. The questionnaire is under related resources downloads. The potential donors can fill it out, and they can fax it to us, or they can email it to us to livingdonorliver@nm.org. If you have any questions, I'll be more than happy to take your question, or as soon as you return to our hospital, and our team will be answering your question or concern. Thank you very much, and welcome to Northwestern Medicine.